and welcome to the newest edition of my book talks. I'm coming to you as a disembodied head in front of my husband's super geeky bookshelf. It took me a really long time to figure out how to make myself look like a disembodied head. I'm pretty excited about it. There's some of this over here sparkling around. I'm gonna work on this. I enjoy being a disembodied head. Today's topic is books for people with a short attention span. So, of course, I need to use these aggressive special effects to keep you interested. Speaking of short attention span, I've had enough of this effect. So it is I, Mrs. Fecteau, and I'm changing things up a little bit. I am no longer going to pretend like this video is just for 11th graders who are helping me choose summer reading books. Now, 11th graders, I would still love you to help me choose summer reading books, but I'm going to make this be more just general book talks of books that either I have read and really enjoyed or have been recommended by others to me so that it can have a wider audience. But if you are a Beverly High School student, particularly juniors who have been through summer reading a bunch before, I would love it if you would give me some feedback. There's a link in the below where the comments would be if I were brave enough to take comments, but you can make comments through using the survey. The books today that we're looking at, as I said earlier, are short attention span books. These are books that, for whatever reason, either they're chopped up into bite-sized pieces or they're books that you can pick up and put down without too much difficulty. NPR, National Public Radio, helped put this out. It's called This I Believe. These are different essays from a bunch of different people, everybody from Helen Keller to Temple Grandin to John Updike. These are essays by a bunch of really interesting people, mostly from the 20th century. Each piece, according to the back of this, compels us to think not only how we have arrived at our own personal beliefs, but also the extent to which we share them with others. The result is a stirring and provocative trip inside the minds and hearts of a diverse group of people whose beliefs, and the remarkably varied ways in which they choose to express them, reveal the American spirit at its best. That sounds good. I would like to thank Ms. Hirschfeld in this particular video because she has read a lot of these and has told me that they are worth reading. So This I Believe, this is one that you can read in bite-sized pieces. Hope Nation is written by a bunch of different young adult authors who you may be familiar with. Libba Bray, Allie Carter, Gail Forman, David Levithan, Marie Lu, Jason Reynolds, Nick Stone, Angie Thomas, Nicola Yoon. These are all authors who have been on summer reading in the past. And what Hope Nation does is them talking about times when they needed hope, when they relied on hope, when hope came through for them. We all experience moments when we struggle to understand the state of the world. We all experience moments when we struggle to understand the state of the world. I don't know if this has any implications in our current situation. So these are essays of hope that I am probably going to read as soon as I finish making this video, because dang, I could use some. Next up are some short story books. The first one is Black Enough. This is by Ibi Zoboi, who's a very well-respected young adult author. And it's a collection of short stories about the Black experience. And it's written by different young adult authors who you have seen on the summer reading list before. Justina Erland formerly wrote about zombies. In this book, she's writing about kissing. Nick Stone talks about a girl who is dating a boy her parents would not approve of. They're not all romance stories. Jason Reynolds writes about three friends walking back from a community pool, just talking about everything and nothing. The book has a lot of different perspectives of growing up, being Black, of being young, and it looks tremendous. This book I have actually read open mic. It's edited by Metalli Perkins, who's one of my favorite writers, and it is a series of short stories about living between cultures. There are a lot of really good authors in here. Debbie Rigo, who wrote Truly Madly Royally, which is a possible pick for this summer, is in here. Metalli Perkins herself has written one. Varian Johnson, who wrote The Parker Inheritance, which was on summer reading last year, which I adored. And Francisco Stork, in front of whom I actually started crying when I met him at a library convention once because I loved his book so much. So that's a little slice of embarrassment from me. Anyway, open mic is generally the stories are funny and appealing, and I enjoyed them very much. The last book is Shout. Shout is a memoir in verse by Laurie Hall Sanderson. She wrote Speak, which I mentioned in the graphic novel video. It's not an easy book to get through, and neither is Shout. Shout is her telling her story of growing up, of becoming a writer, And the incident that takes place in Speak happened to her in real life. And that's a big part of it. It's not, again, it's not an easy read. And I don't think I would recommend it for younger readers just because I think it's kind of scary. But for definitely for juniors and seniors, it's something that might have interest for you. It's a first-person account of coming from a place of really fear and damage and taking that and twisting it and turning it into a powerful impact on a lot of people through her writing. Your bonus content today is something for the short attention span called Where the Wild Things Are. You may remember this from your childhood, but I bet you don't remember it read by Christopher Walken. And other than that, that's it. So short. I will be back with more things. I will attempt to be a disembodied head again in the future, and I hope you have a great day.